for the dark hours when you dare not close your eyes.
No sleep.
It's the No Sleep Podcast.
No sleep.
Featuring stories from Reddit.com's No Sleep Forum.
No sleep.
Join us as the sleepless hours tick past. Our first tale is entitled Kenneth, written by Huxley Adams and read by Christopher Most.
Back in the mid-90s, I used to work at a film processing store. People would bring in their film to be developed, and we'd do it for a nominal fee. My boss was a creepy scumbag who would make copies of people's photos for himself if they showed enough skin. We really should have reported his behavior, but we were afraid of the whole place getting shut down with a lawsuit, and we'd have to go find new jobs. Needless to say, the jobs paid the bills, so I kept my mouth shut. We got lots of tourists who would bring in their vacation photos to be developed, never to be seen again. But we had regulars too, mostly moms who would bring in reel after reel of their kids' sports games, birthday parties, and graduation ceremonies. And then there was Kenneth. Kenneth was a man in his 40s. I met him on my first shift and saw him every Thursday night after that. He'd bring in the same thing every time. One reel of film in a small black canister, with two rolls of quarters to pay for the development. He never said much to me, and I only learned his name after about a year after I started working there, despite seeing him every week. The processing machine we had did all the development work, so the only time I'd ever see people's photos was when I was removing them from the print tray and placing them in the envelope we'd return them to the customers in. I wasn't much of a creeper myself, so I'd never go out of my way to check out people's pictures. But Kenneth's photos were different. Well, I said photos when I should have said photo, because there was only ever one photo on each reel he would bring in. The rest of the negatives were always blank. Those single photos were always similar, two people standing in the window of a house. At first I thought maybe Kenneth was some kind of voyeur, because it would often appear as though the pictures were taken from the street, and it was never obvious that the people knew they were being photographed. The composition of the photos were almost always the same as well. One person peering through the window towards the camera, with the second person standing behind them, partially obscured, to the left. There was nothing suspicious about any of the photos, though, and everyone was always fully clothed. Kenneth would bring in these photos to be developed for years. I never asked him about them, because technically we weren't supposed to be examining people's photos too closely. I mean, if we saw the photos were of a crime, we had to report them, but nothing illegal was ever happening in Kenneth's pictures. It was always just two people standing in a window. About 3 years after first meeting Kenneth, he brought in a reel of film as usual, and I developed it. But I noticed that the picture on the reel only had one person in it this time. I decided to try and spark up some conversation with Kenneth, so I mentioned it. Trying something new? What do you mean? He said. His eyes widened and he ripped open the envelope that the envelope was in. His face went white. I guess your other friend couldn't make it, I said, trying to ease him a bit. He looked worried and his hands were shaking. He only comes when I want him to, he snapped. I was a bit taken aback by his answer. I'd never seen Kenneth upset before. He'd always had such a pleasant demeanor. And he didn't just look upset, he looked scared. I asked him if he was okay, but he said nothing and walked out of the store. That was the last time I ever saw Kenneth. The photo store closed down a couple of years later and I found work elsewhere. Well, it was the last time until 3 days ago. I was working at home in the evening, Thursday night. I live alone and do freelance web design to pay the bills. At about 7:30 at night, I heard a car horn honk from the street outside my apartment. I didn't pay attention to it until I heard it honk again, and again, and again. I went to my window to see what was going on, only to catch a glimpse of someone in a car, snapping a photo of me from the driver's seat before speeding off. Obviously, I was bothered by this, but I didn't call the cops or anything because I didn't really have anything to report. The next morning, I found a small film canister on my doorstep, along with two rolls of quarters. I got the film developed today and wasn't surprised to see that only one photo had been taken on the reel. It was a picture of me, from 3 days earlier, standing at my window, looking out towards the camera. What disturbs me most is that, in the picture, Standing behind me and to the left is Kenneth.